the U.S.-Mexico border. She's a blunt lady, as we all know. Ron Brownstein, the new president of France, Emmanuel Macron, he called the state-run Russian Today and Sputnik news organizations organs of influence and propaganda while standing right next to Vladimir Putin today. Is it unusual to see a French president stand up to Putin in that way and not necessarily see a U.S. president stand up to Putin in that way?
Well, the contrast is striking, if understandable, in the sense that Macron was also the victim of what appeared to be a Russian-generated hack at the end of his campaign. But I think even more striking is the words that Macron used in an interview to describe President Trump, where he compared him to Putin and Erdogan in Turkey in the sense that he argued they all believe that power is all that matters in international relations. And when you combine that with what you heard from Angela Merkel and her foreign minister, and today from the leader of the opposition party in Germany, I think what you're seeing, Wolf, is the European leaders feel emboldened to defend the ideal of an international order built on rules and transnational cooperation on big problems like climate against what they see as the more insular, nationalist, even nativist vision of President Trump. And the fact is that since Trump's election, the nationalist tide has been receding in Europe. I mean, the Trump-like candidates lost in Austria, in the Netherlands, of course, in France, and have faded in the polls in Germany. I think the dynamic is being set up where you will see both Merkel and Macron, I think, increasingly define an alternative visions to Trump's about how the nations of the world should interact.
This is a real serious issue, this U.S. relationship with these very, very close NATO allies.
Yeah, absolutely, Wolf. I mean, in addition to everything that Ron and Admiral Kirby said, I would just add, it's worth repeating every time that these are not just hypothetical alliances. These are countries, Germany and France, that fought with us in Afghanistan for years, even though there weren't always agreements exactly on policy. Absolutely. The fact that there's this daylight between other NATO countries and us right now is, you know, it's disturbing.
And at the heart of all of this, Pamela, is this Russia meddling in the U.S. presidential election investigation that seems to be going on and on and on with no end in sight.